Welcome back, Skippers, presented by Owner's Box Fantasy Sports. Today's segment, final buy low, sell high kind of episode that we're going to do this year. Mm-hmm. Trade deadline's coming up. I know we have ours August 12th. So this time, we're just going to do buy targets for the rest of the season, not sell high. We're going to do guys that we think can help you the rest of the season. It's not even buy low. It's just guys that we can help on the playoff push.
Yes, we want you guys to win your leagues. And obviously, the deadline's coming up, so it didn't really make sense to do sell high right now.
No, it's hard for people to sell high when you're in August as well.
Yeah, so we're going to talk about guys that we want you to go after hard to get on your rosters.
Before we get going, like, comment, subscribe, join the cord. If you can't get into the cord, put it in the comments and we will send you the correct link. Play Owner's Box Weekly Fantasy Sports. Code Skippers5 for a free entry. Jeremy, get into your players.
So my first guy, this guy actually has been, I think it was a couple weeks ago, maybe a month and a bit ago, he was a big buy low target. Eduardo Rodriguez on the Boston Red Sox. His expected ERA is really good compared to his actual ERA. He is battling a couple injuries. I know he left the Jays game. It was before this Jays start. He left with an illness.
Yeah, it was like a stomach problem, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah, but I mean, you look, the Red Sox got no one at the deadline, only Chris Sale's coming back. They're going to be relying on this guy in the rotation. I think he's a great SB5 for any team. If I have him on my roster right now in a keepers league, there's a good chance I'm looking at not keeping Eduardo Rodriguez. So that's exactly why I would target him on someone else's team. If they're low in the rankings, it's most likely they're thinking, okay, like, I'm probably not keeping him because he hasn't been that good. But you can offer whatever draft pick it is based off what's going on in your league. But go get him, and I think he'd be a great addition to any lineup's starting rotation.
His expected stats have been really good, like you said, so I think it's a good target for sure.
Highest K percentage of career as well, just to add on there. I do think the best is to come for Eduardo Rodriguez this year.
Your next guy.
My next buy target is our very own Steven Matz of the Toronto Blue Jays. Avery and I actually saw him live yesterday. Yes. So this will come out tomorrow.
Friday.
Yeah, this will come out Friday. So tomorrow. Well, the days are all mixed up here.
We saw him on Wednesday.
We saw him live. He looked great. His control was awesome. He was up to 95, 96.
Yeah.
I do still, like, we saw him at the start of the year, and he was like, amazing. Everyone's like, Steven Matz, it's going to be.
Look out for him.
I think he was at 1.80% rostered. Then he became a drop. Now I'm saying that you should pick him back up. He had a good start against Cleveland when we saw him live, and he had a good start against the Mets.
He's one of those veteran pitchers that needed the year to kind of get into his rotation, get into his stuff, and now he's just fine-tuning it for a playoff push.
Yes, he's a gamer, and he's going to be, he's found his spot in that rotation with the Jays. Jays are making a playoff push. Every game's going to matter. Lots of wins out there for Steven Matz. He is for sure would be a great SB5 for any team. And you can get him at a very low price still. So I'm going to go with Steven Matz with my second buy target.
I like that. True.
My first buy target for the playoff push is Luis Castillo, pitcher for the Cincinnati Reds. He's been on a lot of episodes, especially at the start of the year when he was one of the worst pitchers in the league. But over the last month, one of the best pitchers in the league. But the thing is, his first half stats still balloon his overall numbers and makes him not look as good as it has been, because last seven starts, 47 strikeouts in 44 innings, 1.81 ERA. So that's pretty darn good. And Statcast profile backs it up, 95th percentile velocity, 87th percentile at minimizing hard contact. The thing is here, you want pitchers that are on teams that are in the playoff battle, like teams that will want to maximize innings from their best pitchers. You don't want teams that are in last place or teams that are way ahead in their division that are going to rest their best players down the stretch. You want guys like on Cincinnati that are in a battle with Milwaukee for the NL Central division. That he's going to pitch all the way through August and September without innings limitations. Other pitchers that I like in this category are Zach Wheeler, Aaron Nola, Hyejin Ryu, Robbie Ray. They're probably a little bit more expensive, but any pitcher you can go out there and you know, like, he's going to be able to give you lots of innings coming down the stretch, that's the guy I want to go get.
Yeah, I think the price is going to be high on Luis Castillo still. People waited on him. They didn't want to drop him. We told people not to drop him, and then he's just figured it out. He's been maybe some of the best stuff of his career. Mm-hmm. The changeup isn't playing, but his four-seam fastball has one of the highest, like, whiff rates in the past month, I think, which is odd for Luis Castillo. But good for him for figuring out, because it was ugly at the start of the year, I'll tell you that.
If you're on a team that's kind of hitter heavy in terms of value and you need to get a pitcher from a guy that's pitcher heavy, this is a guy I would target.
Your next guy.
My next guy is a batter, another Blue Jays pod. It is Teoscar Hernandez, outfielder for the Jays. On the season, 294, 48 runs, 17 home runs, 66 RBI, 343 on base. I'd say he's the most accessible Blue Jays batter in trade talks right now, right? You're not going to probably get Bichette. Mm-hmm. You're not going to get Vlad. You're not going to get Simeon. You're not going to get Springer after this week, especially. So he's definitely, if you want a piece of that lineup, the guy that you can probably still get in a trade. Hitting fourth in the lineup or fifth, great spot for RBI production if you're in a roto league and need some RBIs to catch up. I mean, if you look at his Statcast profile, he is like 90th percentile or better in all power statistics, completely lighting it up red. I still think the price will be kind of reasonable, right? Like,
yeah.
No one's going to make you pay like a top 20 pitcher or another top 20 batter to get him. He's still not seen in that kind of category. So players I would trade for Teoscar include Yelich, Arozarena, Grisham, Gallo, and then pitchers, I trade Musgrove, Hendricks, McCullers, Julio Urias.
It's not bad at all. Good targets there. I'll get into my. I have three people here. My first one's going to be Sonny Gray of the Reds, another Reds pitcher, kind of in the same category. Hasn't had the best year, but I think there's some reason for some optimism here. He's a 4.26 ERA, but his quality of contact is very low. Weighted on base is 3.26, but his expected weighting on base is 2.95, which is good numbers there. ERA is 4.26, but his expected ERA is 3.66. Sonny Gray's done it. We've seen what Sonny Gray can do in a playoff push for a competitive team. I think Sonny Gray is a good chance that you're going to be able to get low for sure. Another guy that I think you can get low is going to be Kenta Maeda of the Twins. Over the last month, though, 2.15 ERA with a 0.82 whip. Kenta Maeda had a very bad first half of the season again. Surprised he didn't get dealt at the deadline. So could hurt his value a little bit as a guy they might shut down, limit a little bit of his innings. But a 4.40 ERA with an expected ERA of 3.77 and a 4.35 slug with his expected slug of 3.85. These numbers show that he's just not living up to what he can do. He's not getting lucky here. But then my third guy is going to be Jameson Taillon of the Yankees. Again, another guy with a very ugly start to the season. People are like, oh, we should drop him early. That's okay. Some people dropped him early. But now I think there's, again, more reason for optimism. Six wins in his last eight outings. High strikeout upside, running the highest strikeout percentage of his career so far. Much more curveball usage, making him more successful recently. And he's on the Yankees. I think the Yankees are going to make a push for the postseason here.
Yeah. I like the picks there. I don't have anything to say against them. I think
I almost picked Sonny Gray. I love that pick.
Yeah.
So I'm not a huge Sonny Gray guy, as I had him as my must avoid players, but
here at the end though,
yeah,
you know, you didn't get the value. So you're kind of right. You avoid him because you didn't think he'd get the value as where he was getting drafted as ADP, and he hasn't given any, like, a lot of value at all to any of his fantasy managers. So I think it was a good pick there. Big brain, Jer.
Thank you.
But that's all I got, boys. Any more comments?
No, make sure you comment below who you want to buy, and we'll comment back and let you know if we think it's a good buy target.
Yeah, keep putting those trades in there. Join the core. You can't get in. Put a comment down there. Like, subscribe. Thanks for everyone for watching. We will see you next time.